Dealing with people. Is this something you need to do when you're a programmer, or can you literally just ignore the world and go into the corner and just start coding 100% of the time? Let's talk about that in today's video. This video is brought to you by the Learn Programming Academy's Python Masterclass. Join close to 120,000 students and get 42 hours of video training, which will teach you Python the right way. Grab a massive discount and instant access by visiting lpa.dev/YouTube Python or by clicking on the link in the description of this video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And we're talking about people skills and whether you actually need to have them. But secondly, do you need to engage with people as a programmer? Well, answer hopefully is going to be fairly obvious is that yes, you will need to engage with people. But what may not be obvious is that this will be a large amount of time that you'll be spending in your career. It will be actually engaging with other people. Now, those people can be your boss. They can be other clients. They can be co-workers. You need to sit back and think that this programming, that this is a code that you're writing, who is it aimed for? Are you writing for a robot, or are you writing for people? That's right. So you're actually coding for a human somewhere, or a group of people, your boss, your client, whoever it is. So for that reason, you're engaging with that person, you're creating a solution for that person, and more than likely, you're going to have to start talking to that person and get on well with these people as well, try and figure out what their needs are. That's really important. So, you know, like it or not, dealing with other people is a necessity as a computer programmer. And there is basically sometimes the false illusions are out there, or basically people coming into the industry that this is a career where you can just literally just sit in the back room and code away. But certainly not. You need to learn to work with people to basically give yourself every opportunity and to increase the chances of you getting promotions and so forth. Because let's face it, if you don't get on well with people, or you're not likable in some ways, you are going to struggle with your career. I mean, that's reality, isn't it? I mean, who would you prefer to speak to? Someone that you like, someone that you get on with, or someone who's a pain in the backside? I think it's pretty obvious that it's the first one, someone that you get on with and you resonate with. So you want to be that type of person when you're dealing with other people. All right, so now that we've identified, hopefully, that hopefully you understand and agree that you need people skills, how do you actually get on with other people? Because this may not be an easy thing to do if you haven't got a lot of experience. First and foremost, in my opinion, is to have some empathy with the person you're dealing with, whether it's your boss, whether it's a client, co-workers, and so forth. Think about it from their scenario and try and get into their head, so to speak, to think where they're coming from when they're talking to you, and basically make sure that in all your interactions, you've got some empathy. Leading on with that, and perhaps very similar, is putting yourself in their shoes. It can be a great thing to do to make sure that when you're talking to someone, you're trying to think from their perspective. Look, what are they trying to achieve? What are they trying to get out of me? Because what are they trying to get out of you? And that will help you understand more where they're coming from. Ultimately, that will lead, believe it or not, to basically better code as well. So it's certainly a win-win. And again, the analogy I use is if you're a pain in the backside, do you think that's going to make things easier for other people? Hopefully the answer is pretty obvious. Obviously it's not. Now, the third thing I want to talk about is listening to other people. And I guess it's very similar to empathy and basically trying to putting yourself into other people's shoes. But listen to people, listen to what they want. Some of us developers, we like to think that we're pretty intelligent. I mean, that's the reality, and perhaps we are, but we have to listen to our audience, to our bosses and clients, co-workers and so forth, because ultimately what we're doing is we're coding, we're creating a solution to other people's problems and basically their needs. We're trying to meet their needs in a software solution, but they're basically paying us for our time. So we really need to actually listen to them to make sure we're understanding where they're coming from. And basically it's all about them. And what we're doing is creating a solution. Another important thing here something that I see happen often is that particularly when talking with end users or people who aren't as technical, who aren't programmers, make sure that you're talking to people at their level. You're not talking about HTML and CSS and JavaScript and all sorts of other things when that doesn't make any sense to the end user. Basically frame it to their needs, because it's like, I'm sure you've seen this before, like if you speak to a builder, an architect or a motor mechanic and they start talking using words that are appropriate for their industry, they'll go right over your head. It certainly does for me. Like I know nothing about cars other than how to drive one. And someone starts talking about cams and gears and literally anything more than an engine, like a carburetor or something, I'm lost. My eyes start glazing over. But if they break it down and just make it simpler for me to understand, they'll get much better results. So it's generally the same thing with reply. Make sure you're talking to people at their level, and that actually is a sign of someone who's really good at what they do. If you can get the person you're speaking to basically understand what you're saying without having to go through all the techno jargon that we as developers often use, that'll be certainly a win-win for you. And again, put yourself in their shoes. What are they trying to achieve? What do they want out of your services? If you do that, basically you're going to be along the right path. And just remember that the solutions that you're providing in general aren't necessarily about what's easy for you. It's all about focusing on what they need and solving your particular client or boss or co-worker's solution. So basically it's, the best way to get results is just to put yourself in these people's shoes, other people's shoes, the people, the clients, bosses, co-workers, etc. And if you do that and take the time to listen to people, have some empathy, you're going to go a long way towards really increasing opportunities for your career, because you're going to be a much more likable person. You're going to get on better with people. And let's face it, in today's society, it's all about communication and so forth. So good luck with it all. Any other questions, hit me up. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.